In the previous classes, we have seen interfacing of what? 7-segment display. Okay, so that we have seen how to display a particular number on display and how the codes are stored in lookup table and how to access them using index and addressing mode. So we have seen all those things. Today we see the biggest interfacing, one of the biggest interfacing of 8051, that is interfacing 4x4 matrix keyboard with 8051. So matrix, you are very much familiar in your intermediate mathematics. You have completely studied, I think, for one semester or for 1 year, matrices. Okay. So matrix is what? It is nothing but simple some arrangement of elements in the fashion of rows and columns. Okay. If you arrange anything in rows and columns, that becomes a matrix. So here we are using 4x4 matrix. That means you will be having 4 rows and you will be having 4 columns. And we will see how to interface this particular keyboard, which is having 4 rows and 4 columns, with 8051. Okay. So before moving to this thing, you should know what is the importance of this matrix method. Why we are preferring this matrix method? Suppose you see, this is microprocessor and I have 4 keys here. And I have got one here. You see at this particular arrow mark, okay, very near to 8051, I got one here. So the controller will understand that it has got one, but it has dilemma that this one has come from which key. Okay, all the 4 keys are connected to same line. If you got some signal here, so this signal has been generated by which key? So there is a confusion. Okay, to avoid that thing, what I can do? I can place 4 different keys. Okay, suppose I got one here, so I may understand 4 is pressed. Suppose I got a signal on the second line. Okay, first line is K4. So if there is some signal here, I can understand K4 is pressed, key 4 is pressed. And if some signal is on second line, I can understand key 3 is pressed. But it's okay for 4 lines or for 8 lines. This is okay.
All but this
practice, you can see on your keyboard, you are having nearly 50 to more than 50 number of keys. So how you can place 50 keys separately? So it becomes difficult. Okay, that is acceptable up to 50. Suppose you want 128 keys, then can you connect 120 lines to your processor? No, it becomes a very, very difficult task and cost also increases and it becomes very complex. To avoid that thing, what we are doing, we are simply using, okay, to avoid that, we are using simply the arrangement of rows and columns. So using 4 rows and 4 columns, I have generated 16 interconnections. Okay, 16, each interconnection will be giving you a key. That means you are able to get how many keys? 16 keys. Suppose you take 5x5, how much you can generate? 25. Suppose you take 8x8, how much you can generate? 64. So in this fashion, it's up to you. You can take any number of interconnections. That interconnections will be connected to keys. Okay. So because of this reason, we are preferring matrix method. Okay. You have a program here. Okay, this is your program. Okay, so to understand this thing, so what is the program? What is the outline of the program? First, you should understand how to write a program and what is the requirement of our program. If you understand that thing, you can easily write the program. Okay, see here. This is the outline of our program. So you have what 8051 is available. You have port 1. Okay, you have port 1. I am using this port 1 lower bits as output port. Okay, complete port is acting as output port. Okay, I am not using these higher bits. Okay, so it is grounded. Similarly, I am using port 2 as input port. Okay, port 2 as input port, and higher bits are also here grounded. And using these lines, 4x4 matrix, I have generated 16 keys starting from 0 to F. Okay, is it okay? Now these P1.0 to P1.3, they are acting as rows R1, R2, R3 and R4. You can see here, okay, 4 rows. Similarly, this P2.0 to P2.3, these are acting as columns, column 1, column 2, column 3, column 4. Okay, and I'm using this third port to display the number which is pressed or the key which is selected on this port 3. So what is happening? See, assume some number, random number, some 9 is pressed. So what will happen? You will be giving some signal through this port 1 output. Okay, if there is an interconnection, suppose this 9 has been pressed, so that number, the signal on this thing is collected by port 2 and given to port 3. The same number is generated on display, 7 segment display. Okay, you are familiar with 7 segment display. In that 7 segment display, you will be using lookup table. You are aware of these things. In the previous class, we have discussed very clearly what is lookup table and how it is storing the codes. Okay, but see, what is the outline of our program? First thing, what you need to understand, this processor has to continuously verify whether any key is pressed or not. Okay, keyboard is available, but any key is pressed or not, that is your first question. Okay, so first requirement is what you need to verify, whether the key is pressed or not, first thing. Second, if it is pressed, so it is from which row, you need to identify. You have four rows, row 1, row 2, row 3 and row 4. So out of these rows, from which row,
Sangeeta,
okay, the key has been pressed, that is your first question. Then after identifying rows, suppose some have taken random number 9, so it belongs to which row? R3. Okay, that is okay, R3, but in R3 you have 4 keys, 8, 9, A and B. But which key is pressed, to be more specific? So I need to verify what? Columns. First you need to verify which row is pressed, then which column. Okay, after finding row and column, you will, if I say, see, 9, number 9 means it is R3 and C2, so definitely the number should be 9. After getting that number 9, okay, you should display the same number on this 7 segment display. So this is our outline of our program. This is the basic idea to write the program for keyboard interfacing. So please observe these things carefully. Okay, once again, you observe this diagram, whole diagram, very carefully. So I will be explaining each and everything here. So I'm starting with P1 port. P1 lower bits, they are acting as output. See, you know, the directions are mentioned here. So these are acting as output. Upper bits are grounded because we are not using. If you are using 8x8 matrix, definitely these lines are also used. Okay, based on our requirement, we are designing only 4x4 matrix. So only 4 lines are used. Similarly, port 2, it is acting as input port. Okay, you can see the direction here. And higher bits we are not using, so I have grounded here. You need to remember one thing. All the ports of 8051 are, by default, they are output ports. Okay, they are output ports by default. If you want to activate them as input ports, you need to give FF. If I want to activate whole port, you can see here, P2.0 to P2.7, whole is what? 8 bits. To activate each and every bit, I should give 1. If you want to activate individual bit, consider this 2.0. If you want to activate this as input bit, so give 1 here, P2.1, you should set this bit. If you want to use, anyhow it will be default, it will be what? It will be acting as output only. P2. Students, are you listening to me or anything wrong? So I got some. Okay. If it is okay, just message me. Please continue. Okay. If it's okay, message continue. Students, are you following me? Okay. So what I was explaining here, see, I was explaining that you should consider this port 2 as input port to get the information which key has been pressed. To activate this port as input, you need to provide FF. Okay, that is the thing about port 2. So after getting the information you are displaying, that is, you know about this part, you are familiar with this port 3 part, that is displaying using 7 segment display. We have seen this in previous program. Okay, one more thing you need to see here, this port 2 is getting the information. That is how it is getting the information. It is connected to VCC. VCC means logic 1. So you are getting the information directly, okay, from logic 1. That means by you are getting what P2.3 is getting 1. Similarly, 2.2 is getting 1. Similarly, it is getting 1. Now you need to observe this thing. This is very important. So four lines are arranged horizontally. Four lines are arranged vertically. Okay. To understand this thing, so they are very close to each other. Okay, they are very close to each other, but these lines are not touching each other. You need to remember this thing. So whenever a key is pressed, consider F is pressed. Then what happens? When a key is pressed, then line row 4 and C4, they will get an interconnection at that particular instant, at that area only they will get an interconnection. Okay, then what happens? The current which is traveling from this P1.3, so that comes down to P2.3. okay, you can see here P1.3, the current was traveling in this direction, it should go to VCC and this resistance path. So you know that current won't choose high resistance path, it will definitely choose what? Low resistance path. Suppose key F is pressed, what will happen? So this R4 and C4, they will get interconnected. Okay, now the current, okay, the current which is coming from P1.3, it comes up to F and then it will turn to this C4 direction. Okay, it will continue in this direction. So now what it is receiving? So we are by default it is activated as 0. So that 0, okay, as a current signal, it will be given to P2.3. So from that you will understand some key is pressed. Okay. See, if no key is pressed, that means what is happening, sir? Simply you can understand that lines are available very close to each other, horizontal lines and vertical lines, they are closely available, but nothing, not the horizontal as well as vertical, not touching each other. So what you will get on this column lines, you will simply get logic 1 from all, because all these are connected to VCC. Okay? Simply you will get all 1s here if no key is pressed. Okay, if any key is pressed, suppose F is pressed, then what will happen? Then they get an interconnection. So the current which is traveling as 0 here, that current will come down to P2.3, okay, in this direction. See the pointer here, in this direction. So what is happening here? It is getting what? 0. Okay, so from that, if any of these bits P2.0 to P2.3, if any of these bits are getting 0, then you can understand some key is pressed. Okay, to give more clarity, I will take rows and columns here. Okay, see here. Now, first thing to check whether any key is pressed or not. So, in port 1 is acting as output port. Output port means by default we should initialize this one with all zeros. Okay, if no key is pressed, no key is pressed means they are very closely available but they are not touching each other. So, what will happen? First case, you concentrate on this. So, you will get, because your VCC is connected, you get 1 here. Similarly, you get 1 here, you get 1 here. So all ones is nothing but what? F. All ones is nothing but F. Suppose a key is pressed. This particular key has been pressed. Now what happens? So this current signal, okay, it has to travel in this direction. You have a resistor here. So current won't choose high resistance path. So it comes, this 0 comes up to this point, finds an interconnection and comes down. So when it is coming down, that means, so this value will not be equal to F. Whenever you see this column's value, it is not equal to F, then you can understand, you can judge that some key is pressed. Okay, some key is pressed. Here, which key is pressed in this particular? We know, we are starting with this, some key is pressed. We will understand that thing. So how to get that thing? Initialize port 1 as all zeros and verify the column values. If the column value is not equal to F, it is not equal to F, then you can understand some key is pressed. But the question arises, which key? Okay, the question arises, which key has been pressed? To know that which key is pressed, what I will do, I will start verifying, I will start guess. Okay, it will be from, I am guessing that it is from row 1. Okay, I will assume that it is from row 1. So if it is not from row 1, you won't get some answer. Okay, so then I will try with R2, then I will try with R3, then I will try with R4. Okay, in our example, I am considering key number 9 is pressed. Okay, so when key number is 9 is pressed means on C2, here you will get what? 0. First thing what you have verified, some key is pressed. But which key? To identify that thing, what I am doing? I am doing verification of all the rows. So I will start with row 1. I have taken R1, R2, R3 and R4 and here C1, C2, C3 and C4. Okay, now, so you are verifying which particular row, then initialize that row with 0 and keep other rows 1. Okay, keep other rows as 1. So we are verifying which row? R1. So what you need to do? R4, R3, R2 should be 1 and R1 should be given as 0. Okay, this 0 is moving through this line. Okay, up to where? Up to this R1. Once again, see this 0 as a current signal, it is traveling continuously up to R1. Okay, now all these column lines C1, C2, C3, C4, okay, these column lines, they are connected to VCC. Okay, so VCC means what you will get down? You will get 1. So here it is also connected as, it is connected to VCC. You will get 1. But what is happening, sir, here there is an interconnection. So interconnection means, so the current which is carrying the signal 1. So this current, you see the pointer here. So the current through this row 3 comes down to this interconnection and comes down as 1. Why? It is initially it is 1, so it is coming down as 1. Once again, C3, no interconnection between rows and columns. It is by default, it is connected to VCC. So what will come down? 1 will come down. And one more thing, coming to C4, can you find any interconnection here? No interconnection is available. That means VCC is connected here. So VCC means logic 1 will come down. Okay. So that means what you need to understand from this, if it is 1, 1, 1, once again it is what? F. When it is F, then you need to understand the key pressed is not from row 1. Okay, once again, if you get the pattern as 1, 1 or F, if the pattern of columns is F or 1, see here, if it is F or all 1s, that means the key pressed is not from R1. Okay, similarly, you can check R2, similarly you can check R3, okay, as we know that it is R3, I am directly verifying R3, okay, see, to verify R3, what I need to do, I need to take R3 as 0, and remaining all rows should be given what value, they should be given 1, only the row which you need to verify, that row has to be 0, okay, now what is happening, come on, see C1 here. So is there any interconnection here? No interconnection. So C1 is connected to VCC. What you will get down? 1. Okay. Now C2, you have an interconnection. Where is the interconnection? On row 3. So now row 3 is carrying which value? Okay, row 3 is carrying what? 0. So this 0 comes up to this interconnection as current signal and comes down as 0. Okay, you will get 0 on C2. Then what you will verify? Then you will verify C3. It is connected to VCC and no interconnection, you will get value as 1. Okay, one more. C4, it is connected to VCC, no interconnection, it will be 1. Now you need to see here, this should not be all 1s or it should not be equal to F. So here you can see this is not equal to F. That means there is a key pressed on this particular row. Which row? Row 3 has the key pressed. Okay. If it is not equal to FF or 0F, if you are comparing only lower bytes, that is F, consider, you may take 0F, FF or anything. So here it is lower byte, concentrate on lower byte. It is not equal to F, that means key pressed is from this particular row. Okay, you have identified row 3, the key is available, but how many keys are available, sir? Here, 1, 8, number 9, number 10, that is A and B. 4 keys are available on this row. You can see the pointer here. So in R3 selected, but in R3 you have number 8, number 9, which is pressed, A and B. But we are assuming that it is pressed, but how the processor should know? So it will verify what column? It will verify column. So which column key is pressed? Okay. So what, by seeing this column pattern 1101, so we can understand, we can see implicitly, sir, C2. In the C2, the key has been pressed, If it is R3 and C2, definitely what should be the number? It should be number 9. You can see here, but the processor won't understand these things. So it will verify in its own manner. So how to verify that thing? See here. If you see the diagram, if you remember the diagram, P2.4 to P2.7, they are connected to ground. So because of that reason, what will happen? They will be carrying what values? Zeros. So remaining thing is what? The pattern. What the pattern is obtained here? See, 1101 is your pattern obtained here. Okay, the pattern obtained is 1101. Now what you will do? You need to perform rotate operations. Okay, you need to perform rotate operations. Rotate right with carry. So what happens, sir? All zeros, four zeros, and 1101 is available here. Now I will perform rotate right carry the accumulator contents. What will happen? For the first time, this one will be placed in carry flag. Carry flag is set. Okay. So when carry flag is set, okay, you understand this part? When carry flag is set, you need to increment this R0 value. Okay. What is this R0 value? I will show here. What is this R0 value? R0 is a register which is carrying the values of this C1 column. It will be carrying 0 when you are verifying R1 row. Okay. R0 register will be carrying value 4 when you are verifying R2. R0 register is carrying 8 when you are verifying R3. Similarly, it is carrying C. So why? What is the idea, sir? The idea is simple. See here, concentrate. The idea is very simple, that if it is this particular key, that is well and good. If it is not this key, then it has to be C1 plus 1. That means it will be from C2, or it may be from C1 plus 2. That means it will be from C3, or it will be from C1 plus 3. That means it will be from C4. That means what I will do, sir? I will initialize R0 with this value, okay, initial value or C1 values, column 1 values, and I will increment these values so that if it is not 8, it should be 9. If it is not 9, it should be 10. If it is not 10, it should be 11. That is B. Okay, once again, what is the idea to store these values? R0 is carrying 0 when you are verifying R1. It is carrying 4 when you are verifying R2. It is carrying 8 when you are verifying R3. Similarly, it carries C when you are verifying R4. So in our example, what we have taken, sir? We have taken what? R3. So the number is from R3. So what is the value R0 will store? It will store number 8. Then we will verify carry flag is 1 or not. If carry flag is 1, you will increment the value. Okay, you will increment the value. Why you are incrementing the value, I will explain. See. Okay. So this is your number 1101. So when you perform rotate right, what will happen? This number is falling in carry flag. So is this the column in which the key is pressed? No. So it is not pressed. How you can identify if a particular column value is 0? Then you will be identifying that key pressed is available in that column. So because of that reason, when you perform rotate right with carry, when this one is falling in carry flag, if it is set, so then you increment R0 value. R0 is carrying 8, so you will come to this thing, 9. Now what happens? Now you will rotate this 0. So when carry flag is getting 0 value, then you will understand, okay, then you will understand that the key pressed is available in this column. Hence, what you will do? You will collect this number, collect this information and give to P2, port 2, and the same information is given to port 3 to display the number. See here. Okay. So R0 is having what? When you are verifying R2. When you are verifying R3, row 3, R0 value is what? 8. Now you perform rotate right first time. What you will get? Carry flag is 1. Okay. It is not 0. So what you will do? Increment R0. So R0 becomes 9. Now once again you perform rotate. Rotate, then what happened? The second number 0 will come down here. So in 0 will come in carry flag. That means this particular key has been pressed. Okay. So whatever we have seen, everything is available in the program. Okay. See, coming to program. So first thing is what? You need to verify what? Any key is pressed So this part is explaining you about the key is pressed. Okay, key is pressed or not, the same thing we have discussed now here. This part, check part is for what? To verify whether the key is pressed or not. How you are verifying the key is pressed or not? Simply you will give four zeros on rows and you will see if this column values is not equal to F. If it is not equal to F, then some key is pressed. Okay, you have seen that thing with the help of this diagram. Now second part, to verify any of the row is pressed, what you will do? So you will guess it is from R1, give zero to that thing and all other rows are given one, and then you will see these columns are getting zero or not. If you are getting zero, then the key pressed is from that row. If it is not, if it is equal to F, key pressed is not from that row. Okay, the second part is very available here. What is this for, sir? To check if key pressed is from R1. Similarly, the same thing will continue. To check if the key pressed is from R2, the same thing will continue. To check whether the key is pressed from R3, the program, and finally, if it is not from R1, if it is not from R2, if it is not from R3, so definitely what you can assume, sir, definitely it is from R4. Okay. Then what you will do while verifying if row is pressed, consider it is not in row 1, it is not in row 2, but in our example what we have taken 9, so it is in R3. So after verifying these things, okay, what you will do, you will jump to column check. So now you have got row, but you need to verify from which column this number is pressed. So then what you will do, you will, after identifying the row, you will jump to column. So I have taken a column check label, then you will jump to here, and what you have performed, I have explained the same part here. So carry, you will perform rotate right with carry Y. So initially these are zeros, 42 bits will be 0 Y because you have connected them to ground, and the pattern of columns will be available here. You will perform jump, you will perform rotate right with carry. So what the pattern was available, sir? 1101. Okay, 1101. First time you perform this rotate right, you will get carry flag as 1. So what I am mentioning here, jump if no carry to display. What he is mentioning, sir, if no carry you jump to display, but you have generated a carry here, so will it jump? No, it won't jump, and it will increment R0 value. So R0 is what it is having, what that particular row's first number. So row 3 is identified. Row 3's first number is what you can see here. Okay, row 3 first value is what? 8. So 8 is available. Now using this increment, it becomes 9. Then S jump to column check. Once again, you come here and you see what you perform, rotate rate with carry. So 1101, 0, 1 is already available in carry. So 0 is available now. So when you perform rotate rate, the 0 comes in carry flag. So jump if no carry. Have you generated carry here? No. Because of that reason, what will happen? It will jump to this display. So which number has been selected? Number 9. So that number 9. Okay. You have seen this in 7 segment display. If you want to display a number, what you need to do, sir? You need to take that value into A and write this magical instruction. Then you can display that number on your 7 segment display. So 9 is available here. That is taken into A. And move code a.dptr, and then you need to display where on 7 segment display that is available on P3. Okay, P3. So one thing first, we will see what is the content of program, and then I have taken some examples. Some key is pressed, what will happen? Then if another key is pressed, what will happen? Okay. First, what we will do, we will see what is available in program, and parallelly we will see the example. Okay. Consider the example. Okay, I will take example. Okay. Assume key 9 is pressed. My assumption is that some key is pressed. Okay. But what is happening in the program? I will explain these two things simultaneously. Okay. Just it's like a revision. Just see here. If key 9 is pressed, what will happen, sir? First thing is that you have seen in outline of the program that first you need to verify the key is pressed or not. For that, what you will do, you will simply give out from port 1 all zeros of lower bits and verify the pattern of these columns. Because it is 0 here, what is happening, sir? So this 0 and interconnection is available here. So this 0 as a current signal comes to this interconnection and comes down, okay? And other columns, they are directly connected to what? VCC. So they are giving 1. So and this pattern of columns is not equal to 0F. Why 0 means? Port 2 initial bits are what? Grounded. So lower bits is F. So this pattern is not equal to F means what? You can confirm, simply you can confirm some key is pressed. The question arises which row and which column. So I am guessing, I will start guessing that it is from R1 or from R2 or from R3 and R4. To verify that, what I am doing, sir? To verify R1. So to verify R1, what I am doing? I will simply place 0 on R1 and all other things will be placed as 1. So all these things are what? 1110 will be given through port 1 and you will verify the pattern of columns. Okay, you see the row 0 here. So this current signal 0 is coming through this line, but is it finding any interconnection? No interconnection. Interconnection is not available. Simply this 0 will be given to the resistor. Okay, now coming to verification of columns. So C1, no interconnection is available here. So what will happen? It is connected to VCC. It takes down 1. Once again, it is also connected to VCC, but there is an interconnection. So what happens? The current which is available at this P2.2, that comes to the interconnection and comes down as 1. So because here you have the value as 1, you are getting 1. Similarly, here nothing is available as interconnection, so you will get 1. No interconnection, you will get 1. So this is equal to F. So this is equal to S. F means, see here, means the key is not in this row. So the key is not in which row? It is not in row 1. Okay, it is not in row 1. Second thing, what you will verify for row 2, what you will do, sir? So row 2 value will be 0, remaining other values will be 1. Okay, now verify C1. No interconnection, comes down as 1. Okay, here an interconnection is available, but what is the signal available here? It is 1, so it comes down as 1. No interconnection, comes down as 1. It is not equal to, it is equal to 0F. Equal to 0F means it is the key pressed is not available in this row. So I will verify next row. So here I have given what? 0 to that particular row to verify the key is pressed or not. So no interconnection, 1 will come down. Here is an interconnection. So this 0 as current signal, it will come to interconnection and comes down. Okay, that's it. So what is the point to consider here? This pattern is not equal to 0F. That means key pressed is available in this particular row, row 3. But the question arises once again, sir, which column? By seeing this pattern simply, okay, you and me, we can decide that it is column 2. But processor won't understand. Okay, so there should be some mathematical operation to decide from which column has been selected. Okay, now I will take that pattern into A. So A, it will get zeros because port two upper parts are what? Grounded. Pattern is what? 1101. So initially assume any value or 0. Now you perform rotate write with carry. So what happens with carry means this carry, I am assuming 0, so that 0 comes here. Okay, and you will shift these things. What happens, this last number will come into carry flag. See, in the program what you have seen, just see once, what is the program part? Jump if no carry to display. If no carry, you need to jump to display. Okay, but what you have seen here, there is a carry, so it won't jump. Next instruction is what? Increment R0. R0 is what? Initial value, okay, column 1 value of that particular row. So 8 is in this row, 8. So you will increment 8 to 9. Okay, now once again, what you will do, you will perform rotate write with carry. So this 1 available in carry, you can see with the help of pointer, this comes at first as MSB and shifting, and then you will get 0. So if it is not jump if no carry, so if it is not 1 means carry has generated, so you will jump to display and you will display what number? 9. Okay, I hope this is very clear. So now we will verify the programming part. Okay, parallelly I will explain the diagram also. So before starting, you need to initialize something. What? Why you need to initialize, sir? So DPTR has to be initialized with 0400. Why it has to be initialized with 0400 means, I have lookup table. Okay, lookup table. I am considering the starting location of this lookup table is from 0400, and the codes available for these keys 0 to F, they are available in this lookup table. Okay, starting from 0 to F, they are available here. So for that reason, I need to initialize what? First thing is what? I need to do some initializations. So I am initializing DPTR register with 0400. And one more thing, move P2, 0FF. So I have mentioned earlier what? All the ports in 8051 are default, they are acting as output ports. If you want to make that port as input port, you should give FF. So we are not giving FF directly because assembler may understand this as variable. To avoid that confusion, simply place 0 here. So it will take this as number. Okay, to avoid that confusion, it will take FF. So port 2 is acting as input. Why it is acting, sir? See here, see the diagram. So if you remember the diagram, we can easily do. So each time we need not come here. So port 1, it is default, it will act as output port. Port 2, it is acting as what? Input port. So input port. If you want to make this as input port, what you need to do? You need to initialize it with value of FF. So I have done the same thing here. Okay. Now, this part is what? Checking the key is pressed or not. Okay. Move P1, #00. Why, sir? Why you have given 00? You can see this thing. So we have seen what? In checking process, you should give port 1 value as 00. And then you see any 0 is coming down. If any 0 is coming down in column pattern, then some key is pressed. Okay. For that reason, what I have written, sir, here, I have written move P1, #00. So higher bytes, anyhow, they are grounded. Lower bytes, they will get all zeros. Now what you need to do, sir, move A, P2. P2 is what, sir? P2 is what? Pattern of columns. So columns, in our example, we see here this particular thing. So this column will be taken in P2. Okay. The P2 content is this thing, and it is taken into accumulator register. Okay. 1101 is a pattern. So that pattern is taken into A. And what you will verify, sir, you will verify whether this pattern is equal to F or not. Compare and F not equal. #0F. So what it is doing, comparing and jump into this location if content of accumulator is not equal to AFF. So what is the pattern, sir, you have obtained in our example? Because the key is pressed, this is not equal to F. Okay, so you have understood that some key is pressed. When key is pressed, you need to jump to that particular label. Okay, see here, compare and jump if not equal. 1101, it is not equal to F. So you will jump to which thing? You will jump to label pressed. Okay, now you know that some key is pressed, but which key, which row and which column, you have some doubt. So to get your doubt cleared, what you will do? You will verify R1, R2, R3 and R4. So I'm starting with R1 here. Okay, what I'm doing, sir, move R0, #00H. So you remember one thing, in everything you will see these numbers. R0 will be carrying starting number of that row starting number. So 00 is number, starting number in row 1. So 4 is what? Starting number in R1. Similarly, you can see in R3, first number is what? 8. In row 4, what you can see, the starting number is C. Okay. Just I will explain this thing in our main diagram. See here, row R0 is a register which is carrying the starting value of the respective row. So in when you are verifying row 1, R0 should be given what value? 0. Second time, R0 should be given which value? 4. Third time, R3, should be given, R naught will be given what value? 8. And when we are verifying R4, R naught should be given with value C. Okay, the same thing is continuing here. You can see the same thing in program. So to verify the row 1, I am giving 0 value into R naught. Then what I will do, sir? Move T1 comma 0E. What is this 0E, sir? See, 0E. 0E. So what is this number, sir? Triple one zero. This is what E. So initial 8 bits, higher order bits are 0. So that becomes 0 and E. This is what pattern of rows. 1110, it is E, and initial bits are all set to ground, so it is 0. So the whole number becomes what? 0E. So this number has to be loaded into what? Rows. Okay. For that, what you will do, sir? See here. You will load this number into P1, because P1 is giving out the pattern of rows. P1 is giving out the pattern of rows. So you will load what? 0E to verify keep rest is in 0 or R1 or not. Clear? Now see the same thing. See, if you understand this particular part, row 1 part, you can understand, simply you can do by yourself. Now, you have loaded what? 0E into P1. That means here, you have given the pattern of row 1. Okay? You have given the pattern of rows. Now, what you will verify, sir? You will verify this number, okay, this pattern of columns, it is equal to 0F or not, and these lines are connected to, these columns are connected to what? Port 2, okay? So, for that reason, what I am writing, sir, see, okay? Move A comma port 2, the pattern of columns is moved into A, okay? What is happening? Pattern of columns is moved into A. Now, what you will do, you will compare. Compare and jump if not equal, A and 0F value will be compared. If it is not equal, you will jump to column check. See here, in the example, what is the column pattern, sir? For the first time, for row 1 verification, the column pattern is what? 0F. So will it jump to column check? No, it won't jump to column check. Okay. What it will do, it won't jump to column check, means it will continue with row 2. When you are verifying row 2, the starting value should be what? It is what? 8. So it has to be loaded in R naught. And the pattern, what is the pattern for row 2? Second time, what is the pattern? To verify row 2, I am writing what? 1101. 1101, what is the value, sir? It is 0D. So I am loading this 0D where? Okay. I am loading this 0D on port 1. Okay. Port 1. Where is your port 1? So 0D value is loaded into port 1. Okay. This is what pattern of rows. Now you need to verify pattern of columns. There is a pattern. Move A comma P2. Okay, the content which is available on P2, that is what column pattern will be loaded into A. And you will verify the column pattern is equal to 0F or not. If it is not equal, then you will jump to column check. Okay. If it is equal, you continue with next thing. In our example, what is the value, sir? We are getting 0F for row 2. That means keep rest is not available in row 2. So you will continue with row 3 verification. For verifying the row 3, what is the condition, sir? First number of this row has to be loaded into R naught. Clear? Now, you need to generate a pattern. What is the pattern? See here. Pattern is what? Row 3, you have selected row 3 for verification. That has to be 0 and all other things has to be 1-1. Okay? So it is what? 1011. Okay? 1011 means which value? B. So that B has to be loaded into P1, and pattern of columns is available in P2, that has to be loaded into A, and you need to compare this value. See here, in our example we have taken this and you got a value, the pattern as 1101. So is it equal to FF or 0F? No, it is not equal to 0F or FF. So you don't consider this higher bit, consider only lower bit. So it is not equal to F. That means the row 3 is having the key pressed. So what you will do, you will jump to this column check. Where is this column check? Column check is here. Okay. I will explain the same thing in diagram part. See, 0 and this pattern of columns is not equal to 0f. That means keep rest is from row 3. And now you will jump to what? Column verification. What you will do in the column verification? You will rotate right accumulator content and see that carry flag is not set. Not set means it should be 0. If it is set, you will increment R0. If it is not set, you will decide that this number is the keep rest and you will jump to display. Okay. Now what has happened, sir, here? You have verified that this number is available here. You will jump to column check. You will perform rotate rate with carry operation. Pattern is what? 1101. Okay. 1101. You will perform rotates and you will verify. First time 1101. One is not. Okay. One will be given into carry flag. So it is set. If it is not set, it will jump. So it will increment R0. R0 becomes 9. Second time when you are rotating, it becomes 0. So it is not carry. Carry has not generated. So you will jump to this display. Carrying number. Number is available as 9 in R0. So what will happen, sir, with this thing? In 7 segment display, you have seen this part. If you want to display a number, take that number in accumulator and write this instruction. Okay. 9 is taken in A. From move C A comma at the rate A plus DPTR, what will happen? The code of 9 will be taken into A, and your LED, your 7 segment display, which is also of LED, you may have of LED 7 segment display is available here in port 3. So through port 3, you will give out the number or the code available in A into this 7 segment display. So using what instruction? P3 comma A. Okay, you have verified one key is pressed. Second time some other key may be pressed. So what you will do? You will jump to, you will perform a short jump to check. Check is what? Here. The label here. So once again you will start continuously checking. So if key is not pressed, you will perform short jump to check. That means it is what? Infinite loop. So continuously it is checking the key is pressed or not. Key is pressed or not. If key is pressed, then it starts the process of verifying rows and columns. It will verify rows first and then it will verify columns. So if a row is detected, then it will verify using the column pattern, puts in accumulator, perform rotate operation. If it is not carry, it will jump to display section. Clear? So I will take another example. It will be very easy. See, for the second time, what I am assuming, key E is pressed. E is available in R4. Okay. In R4, key E is available. Now what you will do, sir, first thing is what? To verify key is pressed or not, you will give pattern as 0. See here. It is not interconnection is not available. So one will come down. Interconnection is not available. One will come down. Interconnection is available. So this 0. Okay. This 0 comes up to this interconnection and comes down. So this pattern of columns is not equal to 0f. If it is not equal to 0f, what is your conclusion? Key is pressed. But the question is which key and which row and which column. To verify the rows, I will start with R1, R2 and continue up to R4. So to verify R1, I will place R1 value as 0 and all other values as 1 into P1, port 1. So because these are coming from port 1. And now I will verify column pattern and give it to P2. See here, it is connected to VCC, no interconnection, one will come down, no interconnection, one will come down. Here is an interconnection, but what is happening, sir? One is available here, so this one will come as current signal to this interconnection and it will come down. See here, one will come to this interconnection, it will come down. Okay, this thing will happen. And last column, it is no interconnection is available, directly it is connected to VCC, it will come down as 1. You will verify, is it equal to 0f? Yes. It is equal to 0f. That means key pressed is not available in this row. So can you see any interconnection on this row 0? No. So it is not the desired row. So what you will do? You will verify R2 here. You will come to verification of R2. Okay. Verification of R2 means you will place 0 on R2. Remaining will be 1. And you will start. No interconnection, 1 will come down. No interconnection, 1 will come down. Interconnection. But what is the value? So this one will come to this interconnection and come down as one. Okay, no interconnection, one will come down. Okay, so you will get 0F pattern. That means no key is pressed in this row. Once again, you will verify R3. No interconnection, it will come down as one. No interconnection, it will come down as one. There is interconnection, but where is the interconnection? The value 1 is coming to the interconnection, coming down. No interconnection, 1 will come down. 0 is available in R3, but no interconnection on R3. So it will move to this resistor value. Okay. Now coming to R4. What will happen, sir? No interconnection, 1 will come down. No interconnection, 1 will come down. Here is an interconnection. So 0 will come to this interconnection. It will come down to 0. Come down as 0. So this value is not equal to 0F. That means key is pressed. Key pressed is available in R4. So you are happy that you got row, but have you got the information of column? Yes, the information is available. You and me can, by seeing this, you can say, so this is column 3 and R4. That means definitely this number has to be E, but the processor won't understand in this fashion. It will do some mathematical operations and then it will conclude. So what you will do, you will take this pattern of columns in P2. Okay, so P2 contents will be loaded into accumulator. Okay, and R0 will be having what? R0 every time will be carrying the starting value of that row. So you are verifying R4, starting value of R4 is what? 0C, it will be available in R0. So A contents are what? All zeros, 00 and 1011. Carry flag is 0. So first time when you perform rotate, carry becomes 1. Carry is set, not equal to 0 means simply you will increment R0 value and once again you will perform rotate. So once again, second time carry is 1, not equal to 0, it will increment the value. That is what OE. Sorry, this is not OE, this is 0E. Okay. Then once again you will perform rotate operation, but this time this value comes here, this LSB bit comes here. So carry flag is not set. So when carry is not generated, so jump. If no carry to display, what it will do, sir, it will jump to the display. And what is the number which is available in R0? Number available in R0 here is 0E. Now the corresponding code of this 0E will be taken from our lookup table and it will be displayed on the display. Seven segment display available on port 3. Is it clear? Okay, I think what you do, you simply do this operation. Okay. To get better clarity, you do this thing. Okay. What you will do, take a number, random number, consider some number 5 or 6. Do column first, a key is pressed or not using this thing. Then you start checking R1, R2, R3 and R4. Then you perform these things. So once or twice, if you take two random numbers and you write in your own way, okay, then you will understand how easy this program. It looks a little bit tough because the length of the program is large, but if you observe clearly, it is simply repetition of this part. So what you are doing to repeat, what you are doing to check R1, same thing is continuing here. What will change? Starting value of R1 will change. Okay, starting value of this pattern of row will also change. Okay. So instructions are same, only data values are changing. Once again, instructions are same, but one more thing, you have not written here CJNE A, hash 0F column check, because anyhow, if it is not from R1, R2, R3, definitely it will be from R4, and after verifying R4, you will perform column check here. If you write this instruction CJNE, it will jump here, otherwise normally it will come to this thing. So that means if you are performing this jump, if you are writing the instruction jump here also, it is okay. But you are wasting the time of processor. To avoid that thing, no need to write CJNE in verification of R4. Okay. If you have any doubts, you can ask. Okay, students, if you have any doubt, please ask. The program looks a little bit tough, but it is very, very easy. If you follow the pattern, in which I have explained you, it becomes very easy. Immediately after the completion of our class, what you do, you take that diagram, okay, take the diagram, randomly take some number and do the procedure what I have explained in the last slides, okay, then you will understand it in a very easy manner. You will get confidence, okay. Okay, if you have any doubts, please mention message section. So you don't have any doubts. If you don't have any doubts, that is well and good. Okay. So okay, clear. So if it is very clear, that is well and good. If you have any doubts, you can message me in our WhatsApp group also. Okay, I will explain it. Okay, I'm ending this session. And one more thing, I have informed a person, I don't know the person's name, regarding assignment. He has to rewrite the assignment. So the students who have written carelessly, if you are interested, write once again and then submit. It's up to you. Okay, no force, nothing. It's up to you. Because you have written very carelessly, it becomes, it shows your negligence towards the assignment. Okay. Don't do that thing. Better don't write the assignment. So some students have done this thing. Okay. Okay, I'm ending this session. Thank you.